I highly recommend you do, because they're going to be, if you're a carpenter, if you're a plumber, we're going to use you, and we're going to pour money into building and restoring and expanding churches in the harvest. Remember who these people were originally. These were the Knights Templars that seen the pilgrims safely into the promised land. Well, we're going into the promised land, and we want to raise them up. We want to awaken them to the hour. They're going to see us again safely into the promised land. And brothers and sisters, they were shunned. They were taken down and they were destroyed and lied about because Rome took them down because they had more money than Rome. And you can never, whether you're the Tsars of Russia, whether you're the German aristocracy, whether you're the American public with wealth, you cannot have more than they have. They want it all. They take it to themselves, and they destroy wealthy parties. And Rome destroyed the Knights Templars, and so they went underground, and they became what they are today. But they're waiting for me. That's who they're waiting for, and we'll get that thing going on the road as soon as I can get the Queen of England to hear the message that God has given me to give her. Once she hears what God has asked me to ask her, she will know that I'm the one, and we can get this thing done. Osborne is saying, and he shall magnify himself in his heart. Well, you know, pride takes a toll on everyone. I don't know if, you know, because when I take the bullet to my head, I'm going home. I'm going to be with my Father in heaven. Whatever happens after that, that's the enemy. And he shall, and by peace shall destroy many. Well, yeah, the peace plan that I have destroys many, right? At the foot of the cross, because that's the only peace plan. You see, God used his creature. What the devil meant for evil, God meant for good. He built his new world order, but the problem is he can't get peace in the Middle East. He needs a peace plan. Well, guess who's got it? And guess who's his ride? So it's like double indemnity here. You know, and by peace he shall destroy many. God has a great sense of humor, and he loves us dearly. We're going home. We're going to go home, and we're going to be victorious in the process. He shall also stand up against the prince of princes, the prince of princes, but he shall be broken without hand. The prince of princes. Who's the prince of princes? Who is that? Well, we know that Jesus Christ is the King of Kings. Who is the prince? The prince of darkness. How about that, huh? The prince of princes. The prince of darkness. To stand up against the prince of princes. But he shall be broken without hand. So, it's better that one should die than the whole world to perish. We know that because Caiaphas said that about Jesus. There's a crop circle that actually points to that particular passage out here. And it's better that one should die in the end that we can all be saved. And so God is, you know, God has told me what my call is in life. And though my life is short, I need every single believer who loves Jesus Christ, who wants to save their families, their friends, their neighbors, their next-door neighbors, to support this call. This is God's call. This is God's gift to the world, is his Son. And he said he would have the word spoken to all nations before the end would come. This gives us an opportunity to unite all the nations together and preach that word. It gives us a chance to expose the works of the enemy and to show the world that Jesus Christ is on his way back. It gives us a chance so that way there that those that do get taken out, those who make the first resurrection, the ones that have been deceived and get left behind by the false prophets, the false liars, the false deceivers, will have a chance again to come to the foot of the cross and be martyred rather than to take that mark. Because that mark is nothing more than bagging and tagging. It's like when you take cattle and you brand it and call it your own. Those who take that mark will belong to him for all eternity and forever. And we want to make sure that they're aware of that before they do it. But isn't it better that God intercepts it before the banking system takes over? And before Obama starts doing anything about it? No, we need to stand up and expose the frauds that they are and take our nation back. And the only way to take our nation back is to get help from the Crown of England and get the Masons on board to help us. We have an army. We have a great army. And people who love. You know the greatest weapons that we have? Do you know what the greatest weapons we have as a body of Christ? Love, laughter, and joy. Who can fire a gun at that? Have a good day, and may God richly bless you.
We want to offer you this special exclusive edition of Riverdance, the CIA edition. It has been recorded at 3 times its normal speed, giving the appearance their feet never touch the floor. Steps the Central Intelligence Agency will need to know in eternity. This exclusive offer is only available at whitehorse-radio.com.
Asbestos clothing sold separately.